Dear viewers, now I welcome you to my class 3 of heat exchangers. In this class, I'll be explaining about analysis of heat exchanger. That means this is where I'll get the expression for heat supply. The rate of heat transfer in a heat exchanger can be derived by the analysis part. So now, whatever is written in black is the thing which you need to write in your exam. So whatever it is written in blue, it is for your understandings. Fine, we'll start the analysis with the assumptions. Now the assumptions made while deriving the expression or equation for Q, that is rate of heat transfer, are: point number one, heat exchanger operates under steady state condition. This word steady state condition means all the thermodynamic properties, all the thermodynamic properties doesn't vary with respect to time. That means it remains constant with respect to time. Even if the time is varied, the property doesn't change. For example, we can consider density, specific volumes as an example for these properties. Coming to second point, mass flow rate remains constant. Mass flow rate remains constant and the fluid properties are uniform. That means the word uniform says the fluid properties like velocities, the temperature, the pressure with which the fluid is flowing. So this flow properties doesn't change. That means it remains constant with respect to the positions. Let me elaborate this point. If I consider heat exchangers like this, so the mass flow rate, whatever mass that is entering into the heat exchanger is equal to the mass which is leaving this heat exchanger. So the mass flow rate here and here are same. If I say it is m.1 and here if it is m.2, so this m1 and m2 will be equal. That is what mass flow rate remains constant means. And the fluid properties, it doesn't vary. Like if the density of the fluid is say 1000 kg per meter cube, if I consider water, then it remains same even at this end. That is what this second point is means. So first point says the operation is under steady state. Second point says the flow is under uniform state with constant mass flow rate. Coming to third point, axial heat conduction along the tube is negligible. That means say this particular line, if I am drawing, it is a material, the metal part. There is a heat transfer between this fluid and this fluid. So this is hot. Heat has been transferred to the surface and from this surface to the surrounding fluid. But what about the surface? So that is one particular metal part. So here I have hot fluid and here I have cold fluid. Heat is being transferred from here to this metal, this metal to the cold fluid. But here in the axial direction, there may be heat flow. This heat flow is neglected. That is what third point means. Fine. Coming to the fourth point, outer surface of heat exchanger is assumed to be a perfectly insulated. That means the heat which have reached this outer surface, from here it says the surface is insulated, which means from here there is no heat which is transferring to the surrounding. That means there is no heat loss condition. It speaks about heat loss condition, which says there is no heat loss. That is what perfectly insulated means. Coming to the fifth one, changes in kinetic energy and potential energy of the fluids are negligible. So the potential, what while having a flow, velocity may change, which result in change in kinetic energy. But since we have told that it is uniform, There will be no change in velocity and hence there is no change in kinetic energy. Similarly, potential energy also remains same since mass flow rate is same, since mass flow rate is same and there is nothing like height difference over here. So we will see the product of m into g into h, which is nothing but potential energy, also remains same. So the changes are negligible, that means the values are not changing. Coming to the sixth point, the specific heat within specified temperature range is assumed to be constant, which says that for a range of particular temperature, specific heat doesn't change its value, it is constant. Why do we mention this? In the sense, in actual practice, this specific heat C, it may be Cp or Cv, it is dependent on the temperature. I need to say it is proportional to 1 over temperature, because the specific heat C has a unit of kilojoule per kg Kelvin, right? So this kilojoule is